Hi guys, happy Homebrew Wednesday for Wednesday, May 4th, 2016. So, as you know, I've been gone for a little while, been really busy taking care of my mom and things. Happy to report on that she is getting better, starting to get around a little bit. So that's not taking up quite as much time. So let's go ahead and we'll crack open a brew here. Tonight I think I'll have a cider. Just because it's kind of warm today and it sounds good, so we'll pop that open. And we'll pour us up a glass. One of the reasons that I haven't been able to put out videos the last few weeks is I'm taking a class and it's on Tuesday nights, and that's when I've been doing my Homebrew Wednesday videos, is on Tuesday nights. So that's one of the reasons. I got a couple more weeks of that, but I'm going to try and do them on Mondays for the next couple weeks. Nice carbonation on that. As you can see, it's nice and crystal clear. Cheers, everyone. So yeah, my class on Tuesday night, I've been taking a Citizens Police Academy. It's been a very interesting class. We've learned how to do fingerprinting and things like that. And this last Saturday we went out to the range and did some shooting, and they showed us how to blow some stuff up with the SWAT team out there. So yeah, it's been a pretty interesting class. Besides that, what's been going on? Been really busy at work. We're actually getting ready, just started today, moving into a new building. So going to be really busy the next month. With work and on top of work, trying to get everything moved to the new building. So that's going to occupy a lot of my time. And as you guys know, it's springtime, so I've been doing a lot of yard work. I've got a little bit planted in the garden. I've planted rhubarb and peas so far. Hoping to get some carrots and radishes in this next weekend. And Mother's Day's coming up, so we'll be doing that this weekend. What's been going on in the pub? As you can see, I've put up some new lights around. I've got half done. I'm pretty busy, so I've only got half done. Here's the other string of lights that's going to go around this shelf over here. It's going to look just like this. So yeah, trying to get that done on top of everything else. And brew-wise, I'll pause the camera for a second and I'll show you a few things I got going on. So over here we have moved these out. As you can see, they're nice and clear, ready to be bottled. So I moved those up. Hopefully this next weekend I can get those bottled. This is the apple raspberry, and this one is the crab apple. Both looking like they're ready to be bottled up, so we'll be taking care of those in the next week or two. Just making sure all the sediment settles back down from moving them, and then we'll go ahead and either rack them or bottle them. We'll do a sampling on them, see how they are, if they need to sit another couple weeks, or if they're ready to bottle. And then down here I've got some wine mail that's getting ready to go out. I did get bottling done, and I got some labeling done. Over here, as you can see, my rack is finally full once again. We've got Just Peachy, and we've got Totally Bananas, and we've got Absolutely Grateful. Those are the three that I bottled up here a couple weeks ago. As you can see, they're absolutely crystal clear. Nice looking wine. The only one that I have sampled so far is the banana. And this time, rather than the last time when I had banana wine, you can actually taste the banana on the back end of this wine. It tastes like a Pinot Grigio with a hint of banana on the tail end. So I'll be doing samplings of these. This is the grapes out of my backyard when we first moved into the house. It was 18 months before I could bottle that. Was having some trouble clearing it. As you can see, it finally did clear up. So we got that in a bottle. I'm pretty excited to give that one a taste. I did sample just a little bit when I bottled it, but doesn't do it justice. We'll do a proper tasting on all three of these once I get a chance to do that. Here's a closer look at the lights around the all my wine and my booze rack here behind the bar. Used to have old rope lights on the outside here. We've went ahead and updated and put all LED lights in now. So that's kind of cool. Then if you come over here, my wine racks are all full once again. If you guys remember, they were looking pretty bare. It had been a while with moving and all that was able to get anything bottled up and made. So we're finally starting to get things stocked back up. And here's a peek at the other wine rack. So as you can tell, we've got plenty of wine bottled up. I bottled up 120 bottles of wine a week or so ago. So then we got a few more to bottle up. Just a second and we'll take you in. We'll give you a peek at the watermelon wine. Back in the back there is two more 5-gallon jugs of peach wine. Then we've got some sample batches going on along there. And then this one here that's still cloudy. As you can see, the redness has all fell out of it, but it's still kind of cloudy. So we're going to give that some more time. That's the watermelon wine. So we're going to give it a little bit more time and let that keep clearing up. I had a lot of people that was interested in the watermelon wine, wondering what was going on with it. So there you have it. We still just need to give it some time, let it clear. That's the thing with using fresh fruit. It takes time to clear out. I mean, there are some clearing agents and things that you can use, but that's just using more chemicals. I like to use time, and just because as the wine ages, it tastes better. So I like to use time to clear out the wine. So we'll just give that a little bit more time, 3-4 more weeks. Hopefully it'll be ready to bottle that by then, and we'll go from there. So that's pretty much what's been going on in my neck of the woods over here. Been really busy. I'm still getting a little bit of things done. Not as much as I'd like to, of course. I still got a couple beer kits that I want to get put together. With summer coming up, I want to get another batch of wine coolers going on. I need to get some wine mail out to some guys that were promised. Hopefully I can get that done this week. And that's about it, guys. So until next time, remember, there's always time for a glass of wine. Cheers.